So today, a short but a sweet Illustrator tutorial on some advanced tips when using the pen tool. What is up, people? Welcome back to Satori Graphics, the home of graphic design content right here on YouTube. Now for the first Illustrator pen tool tip, let's first take a look at the basic method to try and recreate this grey line here. And then afterwards, I'm going to show you the advanced tips to improve things. So normally, you might go ahead and grab the pen tool, and then click and make some curved lines like so. However, the problem here is that you don't have full control over the handles, and thus the line doesn't really come out smooth and perfect as we'd wish. You can see in the final outcome how kinked and how jagged the line actually is. So let's move it out of the way and use a different technique. With the pen tool, instead of clicking once and then heading to the second anchor point, hold down the first click and extend out two handles. Now, a quick tip here is that stretching the handles in the direction that you intend to create the line really does help to make some smooth lines. And then for the second anchor point, I can repeat the action of holding down a click and expanding the handles to the direction of the line. Using this tip, you would be able to make some smoother and better pen tool paths in Adobe Illustrator. Also, while still on the vector path, you can hold down the Alt or the Option key to cut a specific handle away from the path, and then you can manipulate it on its own. So as you can see, this technique really results in some smooth pen tool paths. The next one I have showcased on my channel before, but in case you've never seen it, we don't actually need to make curved lines to end up with a decent curved vector path. Instead, we can simply click and add anchor points in the general direction that we wish to go. And then when ready, hold down the Alt Option key and then click once more. You can then manipulate the line like I'm doing here. So many designers find this method easier, especially more beginner users to Adobe Illustrator. You can take your time to use the Alt Option key and create some super smooth curves. So we're now going to go back to the technique of holding down a click and extending the handles outwards, and we're going to try and recreate this line here. But see what happens when I arrive at the sharp turn at the end of the line. My extended handle is far too long, and thus my pen tool path is not going to match the line that I intend to take. Now I can just click the anchor point and continue, but that's quite messy and the line doesn't look so neat and smooth as I'd like it to be. It's pretty kinked and it's sharp in the corner, which isn't what I want. So here's the advanced pen tool tip for this situation. Click and extend the handles out as usual, but when you realize your handle is either too long or too short, hold down the Command key on a Mac or the Control key on a PC, and your pen tool path will be locked in position, but the only difference is that you can manipulate the relevant handle. The handle influences the next course for the path, so you want to have control over it when you're using the pen tool in Illustrator. So again, I will hold down the Command or Control key and stretch out the handles like so, in the direction that I wish to take. And as you can see, the line is a lot more similar to the original one. So moving on to more advanced tips with the Illustrator pen tool, we're going to utilize the Shift key in combination with the techniques that we just used. So when holding down Shift, the handle's fixed to a 45 degree position. And for the S shape here, this is actually really perfect. The second point doesn't require that I use Shift to get the line perfect, but also I'm going to use the Alt Option key to make some adjustments to the path as I go. And then down to the third point, I again will use the Shift function to lock it perfectly vertically. So finally in today's pen tool tips tutorial, let's repeat the same technique, but halfway through making the second point, I might feel that the point is in the wrong position. So I can actually hold down the spacebar and then relocate the anchor point itself. I'll show you that one more time here in the third point. So simply hold down the spacebar on your keyboard and then you can relocate the point. Remember, if you want to keep boosting your skills as a graphic designer, subscribe to my channel for weekly graphic design content. Also subscribe to my backup channel linked down below, and like and share this video on social media if you do find it useful. Until next time guys, design your future today. Peace.